guys down and check us out for a nap.
This is a man, but not the same woman. Puck, have you made a mistake? He was to love another woman, not this one.
Fate must have meddled with my hand, for he wore Athenian clothes. As you said, can we mend what has been mixed up?
Go find the other woman, and by some magic bring her here. I'll charm his eyes till she appears.
I go swifter than the arrow.
Puck vanishes. Oberon leans over Demetrius.
What you see when you awake, do for thy own true love take. Be it beast or boar with bristled hair, wake when something vile is near.
Puck manages to find Helena and Lysander and uses magic to lure them to the place where Demetrius lies sleeping.
Here she is, my king, with a youth I'd mistaken. Shall we watch them for a little bit for our amusement? What fools these mortals be!
Would I be crying tears of love if I were trying to mock you?
You're so cunning. Have you thrown away your vows to Hermia?
I was not in my right mind when I swore to her.
Nor do I think you're in your right mind to give her up.
Let her go to Demetrius. He loves her and he doesn't love you.
All of a sudden, Demetrius wakens and sees Helena.
Helena, goddess divine, what shall I compare thee to?
What? Are you both bent on making fun of me? First, you rival each other to love Hermia. Now you rival to mock me?
Demetrius, I yield my part of Hermia to you. Bequeath me, Helena, for I love her to death.
You can keep Hermia. My feelings for her have vanished. Now my heart is sworn wholly to Helena. Look, here comes Hermia.
There you are, Lysander. Why did you leave me?
Why should I stay when love for Helena has called me away?
What? Say it is not so.
Even she joins them to trick me? Hermia, why would you do this to me, your friend?
Who is doing what to whom? It seems that now both of them love you. It is you who wrongs me.
Have you put them up to this?
What are you talking about?
I suppose you laugh at me behind my back. Well, I'm tired of being made a fool of. I'm leaving.
Stay, my love.
She will not stay for you, but I can compel her. I would lose my life for her love.
Then prove it with your sword.
Gladly, let's go.
Both men draw their swords.
But sweet Lysander.
Desperate, Hermia throws herself at Lysander's legs. He drags her, trying to shake her loose.
Get off, thou cat, thou vile thing. I desire never to see thee more. It's Helena I love.
You thief, you've cut my knight and stolen my love's heart.
Hermia lunges at Helena, ripping at her hair.
Have you no shame? How low would you go that you would tear at me, you little puppet?
Are you insulting my height? It seems their high esteem has made you grow even more immense than you already are. Think me not so short that my nails cannot reach your eyes.
Gentlemen, do not let her hurt me. She may be little, but when she's angry, she's a fierce vixen.
The men try to block Helena from Hermia's slaps and punches.
Insult! Let me at her!
I swear, I've never wronged you, Hermia. I just told Demetrius you fled to these woods in hope that he'd thank me with his devotion, but all he's done is lead me to the wild beasts. I'm going back to Athens.
Good. Who's stopping you?
Lysander and Demetrius make clear that they are. They look at each other fiercely and draw swords again.
Come now, Demetrius, if you dare, let's utilize the right to Helena.
Oberon and Puck watches the group of mortals move off to another part of the forest.
Puck. This has gone too far. Here's what you do. While these rivals seek a place to fight, lead them astray one from another and put them to sleep. Then, crush this other herb in Lysander's eye and remove the error from his sight.
We'll have to work in haste. Night is nearly over.
I'll fly quickly to my queen and win the boy from her. Then I'll release her from the spell and peace will be restored.
Puck finds Demetrius and Lysander dueling in a grove. He causes them to lose each other. Then he makes them drowsy.
Helena stumbles into the same grove and sinks down to rest.
Oh, weary night.
What? Only three? One more makes four. Here she comes.
Hermia enters the grove.
I can no farther crawl. My legs cannot keep pace with my desires. I'll rest until break of day.
Hermia lies down and falls asleep. When all four Athenians are asleep, Puck doses Lysander with the herb.
On the ground, all sleep sound, all apply to you, gentle lover, remedy. When you awake, you shall take full delight in the sight of your former lady's eye. Jack shall have Jill, Nothing will go ill, and all shall be well.
In Titania's grove, Oberon watches the queen doting on Bottom.
Come sit with me and let me pet your furriness. My spirits will wrap flowers around your neck while I pet your great large ears. Come, let us wrap these around your neck.
Scratch my head, spirits, for I must get to the barber. Methinks I am marvelous hairy about the face.
Would you like some music? Perhaps a bite to eat?
Yes, nice gentleman. What would you like to eat?
Truly, I crave a bag of oats, or maybe a good bale of hay. But no bother, I feel a sleep coming on.
Sleep, and I will wind thee in my arms. Spirits, away. Oh, I do love thee so.
Puck suddenly appears beside Oberon.
Welcome, Robin Goodfellow. Isn't this a sweet sight? But I must say, in truth, I began to pity Titania. While she was charmed, I teased her till she asked what favor she could do for me. I told her to give me the changeling boy, and she did so straight away. Now I'll undo this spell.
He touches the herb to her eyes.
Wake now, my sweet queen.
Oberon, what visions I've seen! I dreamt I loved a donkey!
There lies your love.
How did this happen? How I'd loathe the sight of him now!
Puck, take the donkey's head from this fool. Come, Titania.
My king, I hear the morning lark.
Then let us go, and tell me how this happened that I fell in love with a donkey!
Idris and the Duke are out hunting. They stumble upon the four sleeping lovers.
What wood nymphs are these?
No nymphs, but my daughter, and Lysander near. And here's Helena and Demetrius.
This is the day Hermia is to make her choice, is it not? We'll wake them with our hunting horns.
The horns are sounded, and the couples wake up.
Stand and tell what you are doing here.
In truth, Hermia and I were stealing from Athens to be wed.
My lord, I must invoke the law. They nearly defeated us and deprived you of your wife.
But I love Helena now, and she loves me. My desire for Hermia has melted as the snow does. Please, sir, allow your daughter to marry the man she loves.
I will do that.
Well then, lovers, you meet with good fortune. We'll hear the whole story later. Aegeus, these couples shall be wed at my palace. We'll hold a great feast. Come away, all.
The Duke and Aegeus depart. Hermia, still sleepy, rubs her eyes.
I seem to see everything double.
Was the Duke here?
And did he bid us follow him back to Athens?
It seems as if we're all still asleep, yet I found Demetrius like a jewel at last.
Our lovers smile at each other.
Then let's return home and on the way recount our dreams.
As the four lovers leave the enchanted forest, Bottom awakes.